SOSES, a home of excellence, a place remarkable volunteerism and synergy among internal and external stakeholders is evident, a school of hope. Thus, Socorro Central Elementary School and SPED Center caters all types of learners as it adheres the basic principle of inclusive education. It truly ensures that no child should be left behind, that all school children should learn together wherever possible, regardless of any difficulties or differences they may have. The school popularizes and imbibes its famous hashtag, SOSES, the home where Tinabangay is life. Situated at the heart of the municipality of Socorro, Surigao del Norte, the school has a total land area of 30,700 square meters, lying on top of a plateau approximately 40 meters above the ground, facing the Pacific Ocean, where a nice aerial view of the entire municipality can be seen. The island municipality is composed of 14 barangays, covering an area of 12,445 hectares. The town proper is located in the eastern side of the island and is nestled tranquilly along beautiful crystalline coastlines where one can behold the first ray of sunlight arising out of the bosom of the Pacific Ocean. It has many exquisite natural attractions, the most popular of which is the famous Sohotun Cove, which serves as a sanctuary of stingless jellyfishes, which are endemic in the area and of course can only be found inside the very amazing lagoon. Other attractive nature's best can also be found like Crystal Cave, Tiktikan Lagoon, San Roque Giant Mangroves, Magkahuyog Falls, Salug Busay, Kapihan Nature and Adventure Park, and other numerous fine white sand beaches as well as man-made attractions that enticed a number of tourists to flock to the island. The school has stood over a quite number of years, started from just a complete elementary school since established in 1945. It became a central school of the Socorro East District, Division of Surigao, after separating from the district of Dapa, Surigao Island. Socorro Central Elementary School and SPED Center has a school enrollment of 1,334 school children for school year 2020-2021 from the three publishing barangays of Socorro, Surigao del Norte, and a school personnel which comprises 45 regular teachers, 4 SPED teachers, 4 ALS teachers, 2 non-teaching personnel, 2 security guards, 2 utility workers, and 2 school heads. The school has garnered numerous laudable achievements, being recognized as a SPED Center in 2011, declared as APES Accredited Level 1 in 2012, SBM Level 3 Accredited School in 2018, and a Hall of Famer in the implementation of Brigada Escuela National Level Mega Category in the same year. While the school is reaping series of successes in the implementation of various educational programs, the school is trying its best to maintain such accolades of excellence. The administration believes that good school facilities play an integral component of the conditions of learning and student academic success. SOSES strives to provide an effective school facility which is responsive to the changing programs of educational delivery and ensures a physical environment that is comfortable, safe, secure, accessible, and aesthetically pleasing. It's indeed wonderful to know that amidst the challenges brought about by this worldwide health threat of COVID-19 pandemic, the school, together with its stakeholders, remains steadfast in carrying out its mission of providing first-rate education to its learners, the Socoronhan children, using modular distance learning modality fitting to the new normal setup of delivering basic educational services. The school communicates, partnered, and engages its stakeholders using various platforms such as posting through the FB account and FB page of Socorro Central Elementary School and SPED Center, communications done through emails, special group chats, through calls, texts, and limited face-to-face manner observing proper health protocols during this time of pandemic. Through these media platforms, the school provides timely, engaging, updated, and important announcements that cultivate shared governance and responsibility in effectively managing the school, ultimately geared for excellence. Truly, strong synergy exists among school stakeholders in this very part of the Philippines. The recent societal problem of COVID-19 can never daunt us in making our children still avail education the best way they can. As the school prepares for the opening of classes for school year 2020-2021, to ensure the continuity of education and to safeguard the well-being of learners, teachers, and the entire stakeholders of the school, we would like to present to you the basic preparations of the entire school community in order to safely start school year 2020-2021 with the following actions. 1. Revisiting of the school plans SIP, AIP, APP, PPMP with the stakeholders in order to allocate budget intended for the purchase of health kits and additional allocation for the purchase of school supplies for the production of printing of self-learning modules and learning activity sheets. 2. Purchase of COVID-related items including 7 thermal scanners, face masks, and face shields to protect teachers and school personnel. 3. Posting of tarpaulins around the school campus and inside the classrooms, reminding the people to observe proper health protocols. 4. Preparing the classrooms for limited face-to-face classes if the school will reopen for physical actual classes of only 20 pupils. 5. Construction of functional hand washing facilities to emphasize the importance of proper hand washing to prevent the spread of the virus. 6. Conduct of Brigada Eskwela 2020 by doing disinfection and sanitation of offices and classrooms and painting of markings to ensure social distancing. 7. Conduct of remote enrollment, teacher-led enrollment using varied platforms such as online, through drop boxes in some designated areas of the community, calls, texts, emails, group chats, and even limited face-to-face encounter. 8. Mapping of school children to track and trace their respective areas of residences for the purpose of grouping them according to zones per grade level. 9. Conduct of parents' orientation of the basic education learning continuity plan and conduct of psychosocial lecture on mental health and positive discipline for teachers and parents through a limited face-to-face manner by holding separate orientation schedules per grade level just to observe proper health protocols. 10. Upskilling and reskilling of teachers through attendance to various virtual trainings and seminars in preparation for the opening of classes.
Socorro Central Elementary School and SPED Center, as an SBM Level 3 accredited school, heartily manifests all the SBM principles through our school's best practices. We, the school administration, together with our dedicated and committed stakeholders, are in synergy in paving the way to achieve the delivery of quality education for the holistic development of our school children. Thus, we aimed for an enhanced school-based management anchored and guided on the following SBM principles: shared vision, shared mission, shared decision-making, shared governance, collaboration, autonomy, accountability, and transparency.
This principle revolves around the learners. It includes the projects and plans of the school to ensure conducive and effective learning, safety, and welfare of the pupils. In the current times where pandemic has altered our learning system, the school made sure to cope up with the changing times through the implementation of action plans and other productive ways to provide the best for our learners, including their rights. These learners go in different types from regular class, where learners who need more attention, SPED ELSEN, a class for pupils with special needs, SPJ, where pupils who excel best in the field of journalism, ALS, an alternate or substitute learning system For learners who do not have or cannot access formal education in schools, and SPED FL where fast learner pupils belong. Collaboration of all stakeholders, including the local government unit, headed with the municipal mayor and other non-governmental organizations. Projects of the two barangays, namely Project Chambe-Chambe or Championing Basic Education and Feeding Program, particularly for the malnourished learners. Green Sauces program, which was immensely supported by the parents of the learners that they even planted in their respective homes, as well as in line with the Gulayan sa Tahanan, a sub-project under the Green Sauces program. The providing of scholarships to less privileged SOSES pupils through the Kaugmaon Mo Sagot Ko project. The crafting of motivation for the children to measure and encourage their efforts and hard work in school through the recognition reward system. Establishing the grade level monitoring, evaluation, and assessment, or the GLEMEA, for the learners and teachers in order to discuss and give solution to the problems every quarter, like the nutritional status baseline and endline reports MPS by quarter and SOSES enrollment. The school canteen imposed transparency in supporting the Green Sauces project by implementing zero plastic free regulation, particularly with the goods that they sell. The comprehensive conduct of ICT laboratory training to the teachers and pupils to impart more knowledge in computer and technology. The functional action of the school clinic, especially in this time of pandemic, is by donating health kits including bottles of alcohol. The SBM principal too, with full effort, did everything for the betterment and success of the school and its learners through the conduct of the different monitoring tools such as the reading tool, academic outstanding awards criteria, worth learners, and non-academic awards. With the help of the guidance coordinator, who actively established implementations of the school programs to protect the rights of the learners, SOSES is a friendly environment where misunderstandings and other form of violence do not foster, as they are acted immediately before they can even arise. The school's Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council successfully made a contingency plan, including the emergency hotlines, in order for the educators and learners to be aware and eligible of the evacuation places and high-risk or hazardous areas in the school. With the accomplished implementation of the school's best practices, many schools from all over the Siargao Division and other divisions visited us for benchmarking. The success of our best practices is made evident with all the progress and improvement that the school was able to achieve since the implementation. In terms of the Project Chambe Chambe and Feeding Program, the list of malnourished learners went down a huge sum of number, and with regards to the Kaugmaon Mo Sagot Ko Scholarship Program, our enrollees went up high in number, which is a very satisfying thing to know that more children are given the opportunity to go to school. Moreover, the pupils' performances also became even better, that we were able to send learners in national-level competitions such as press conference and science quiz bee. Another major achievement that SOSES bagged was when we were chosen as champion during the Brigada Hall of Fame, and we were able to sustain this triumph for 3 consecutive years. The Green SOSES project has been of huge help to lessen the production of plastic wastes in school, which empowers the conservation of our environment. Overall, every practice that our school upholds has greatly benefited the entire school body, and we are striving to sustain these for not only today, but for the future learners as well.
Paglaong sa tanan, ang among tumong og katudyuan, ang kaalam, kaayuhan, o proteksyon para sa kabataan. Solong inokalidad para sa bata.